We're back at the Special Events Center on the University of Utah campus in Salt Lake City, readying for semifinal game number two. The Sycamores of Indiana State, unbeaten in 32 outings, going against the Blue Demons of DePaul. It's Ray Meyer against Will Hodges. Let's take a look at the matchups, the players. There's more at stake here than just Larry Bird against a five-man starting unit from Chicago. By just getting to the Final Four, DePaul coach Ray Meyer has already realized one dream. Now he'll count on five very good starters who often go all the way to get him the rest of the way. For openers, there's freshman Mark Aguirre. 6'8", 235 pounds. When he takes that bulk inside, he often gets his way. And in a pair of guards, Meyer has great quickness on the floor. Watch right here with a steal, Gary Garland. With the fast break bucket, Clyde Bradshaw. Bradshaw is just a sophomore, but he plays with tremendous poise. He's got that left-handed jumper, gives Meyer great outside firepower, certainly enough to break down any zone. But when the Blue Demons need a clutch basket, they often turn to their senior, their captain on the floor, Gary Garland. That man right there provides the clutch points. In the middle, they've got an unheralded Iron Man in James Mitchem. Mitchem, not spectacular, just does not make a lot of mistakes. Another man who's been nursing a sore knee, the other forward, Curtis Watkins, who runs with the best of them. DePaul, they go with five starters all year long. It has been enough, but will it be enough today to go against the Indiana State Sycamores, who are still trying to make believers of a lot of people, including our Billy Packer? It is the Larry Bird Show that the Indiana State Sycamores count on, and what a show it is. Larry Bird, Mr. Inside, can also take it outside, never forces a shot. Watch what happens when he follows up his own. Among the leading rebounders in the country, when there's people on him, he'll find the open man. He's deadly with his passes. Give him the outside, his range is no range. He just peels it back and puts it up, often all net. And Bill Hodges has some other people that he can count on coming off the bench. For openers, he's got a slick guard, a junior guard in Carl Nix. 6'2 is Nix, and a brave one he is. He'll go among the Giants inside. He plays with poise. He's the quickness man out front. Watch him right here. Jumps with the best of them. Very deceptive. Just 6'2, but can put it up. Outside shooting strength. The Sycamores can count on a lot of people. They don't go deep, but everybody does their job. How about this man, number 23, Steve Reed? Can't find an open man. Puts it up himself. And you've got to wonder if the Sycamores are not indeed Destiny's Darlings this year. Witness this last second shot by Bob Heaton, which won them the title of the Mideast Region. The Indiana State Sycamores, 32-0, and still trying to make believers of a lot of people. Indiana State versus DePaul. What are the keys for those answers? Let's go over to Dick Enberg, Al McGuire, and Billy Packer.
All right, gentlemen, let's boil it down to its simplest terms. Coach, how does DePaul win?
They must create turnovers. They got to stay out of foul trouble. They got to stop Nix. And Curtis Watson got to play 100% healthy.
Stop Nix and not Bird. How does Indiana State win?
Well, I think they got to be able to penetrate the guards offensively, make sure that Larry Bird gets the ball offensively, and get great play out of Heaton and Staley coming off the bench. They've been great in the playoffs.
The beauty and majesty of the mountains surrounding Salt Lake City. It's in the high 50s outside. Inside, temperatures are rising. People are burning up. They can't wait. DePaul and Indiana State are heading for a showdown. A couple of moments ago, Dick Enberg had a chance to talk with DePaul coach Ray Meyer. He's got a word about another very special coach right now. Dick?
That's right. There's more than one sentimental choice in this game we're about to see. Just as many fans will be rooting for Ray Meyer at a late age to win a national championship, so it is for the fans of Indiana State, because the coach today is on the sidelines and a young man has taken his place. But he still is part of the Sycamore coaching staff. With that story, here's Billy Packer.
Thanks an awful lot, Dick. And, of course, we have Bob King with us, the man that really brought the sports program to Indiana State University. Bob, you had a goal in mind, but did you ever dream it would come true so quickly?
Well, this is a little sooner than we had in mind. But we have some fine young men, fine coaching staff, and I'm awful proud of both groups.
You know, you put together the basketball team and the coaching staff. We've all been amazed at the tremendous job that Bill Hodges has done on the bench.
Super.
He's been fantastic, and of course, I think you deserve a lot of credit for that. You molded him, and he gives you credit for it.
Well, he came there when I took over the basketball situation, and he's just a super young man that knows the game, knows how to work with kids, and just great. I'm so proud of him, and Well, the rest of our coaching staff, a couple of them
well,
played
Mel,
for
Mel Daniels, Mel of course, Daniels played for you and been such a big part of this program
right?
for you right here.
Danny King played for me.
Exactly. One of the things, we're just watching some drills that they used out there. These are drills that you put in when you were coaching and they're still
right.
following them.
Well, I think it's real good to loosen them up defensively as well as offensively before a ball game. And we've used those drills for about all 3 years now, and we like them.
Well, we're so proud of your team, so proud that you can be out here and recovering so well. Best of luck to you and your program. Thanks for bringing college basketball to Indiana State University.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Dick?
Okay, Billy Packer, thank you very much. For those of you who may not know, Bob King was forced to the sidelines by a heart attack and brain surgery. Hopefully he's on the road to recovery, and the Indiana State Sycamores have dedicated this title chase to him. If that sounds corny in this day and age, that's too bad, because that's the way it is. For the right to meet the Michigan State Spartans in the final, it's the Sycamores against the Blue Demons. For the player introductions, let's go to our PA announcer, Dan Roberts.
Ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon's second game is between the Blue Demons of DePaul University, champion of the West Regional, and the Sycamores of Indiana State University, champion of the Midwest Regional. And now for the starting lineups. For DePaul, wearing number 32 forward, 6'7", freshman from Chicago, Illinois, Mark Aguirre. For Indiana State, wearing number 40 at forward, 6'8", junior from Rushville, Indiana, Brad Miley. For DePaul, wearing number 30 at forward, 6'6", senior from Harvey, Illinois, Curtis Watkins. For Indiana State, wearing number 42 at forward, 6'7", junior from East St. Louis, Illinois, Alex Gilbert. For DePaul, wearing number 11 at center, 6'9", junior from Albuquerque, New Mexico, James Mitchem. For Indiana State, number 33 at center, 6'9", senior from French Lick, Indiana, Larry Bird. For DePaul, wearing number 24 at guard, 6'5", senior from East Orange, New Jersey, Gary Garland. For Indiana State, number 23 at guard, 6'2", sophomore from Warsaw, Indiana, Steve Reed. For DePaul, number 15 at guard, 6-foot sophomore from East Orange, New Jersey, Clyde Bradshaw. And for Indiana State, number 22 at guard, 6'2", junior from Chicago, Illinois, Carl Nix. A big welcome, please, to the Blue Demons head coach, Ray Meyer. And a welcome to the head coach of Indiana State, Bill Hodges.
Ready to go. The three-man officiating team headed by referee Henry Nichols, Gary Muncy, and Lenny Wirtz, the umpires. Indiana State in white. Bird will not jump center. It'll be Gilbert. And DePaul in blue. Mitchem will leap for the Blue Demons. Controlled by Indiana State. Nix. That was a design play. And the Sycamores jump off to the early lead.
Larry Bird never even caught the ball, just tapped it right in midair.
Watkins on that bad left knee. Mitchem and Bird. Bradshaw. Garland, he's their money shooter.
And although Mitchum's listed at center, he's playing outside to keep Bird away from the board.
Aguirre inside.
They're starting to post up Aguirre. He has more physical strength than Miley. Here he goes.
There he is. Oh, what a block by Gilbert. Alex Gilbert, 6'7" and a half. And he almost changed the lights with that one.
Well, this ought to tip Aguirre off on something. Anytime he beats Miley, he's going to have him to handle. Anytime Gilbert comes over, he's got a dish.
Curtis Watkins, bad knee and all, ties it up for DePaul.
Dick, here's the key to the game. How is Reed going to be able to do bringing that ball up the court?
Reed against Bradshaw. Watkins and Bird. Bird. Oh, what a touch.
Off the glass. And that's something they're going to have to be patient with. Larry Bird's going to make that shot all day anyhow. They got to just make sure that the other players don't get any action.
That's what Ray Meyer said. He's going to let Bird have his points, try to stop the other four. Garland, 25-footer. It's tied at four.
Music Man is starting to play early in the game. He's deceptive, a lot bigger, about 6'4" and a half.
Watch, he places his hands down by his sides. Watch how he steals the ball.
Nix. Bird open. Through the hands of Bird. Nix threw it a bit too hard. Bradshaw. Great speed. All the way. DePaul leads for the first time.
Clyde to Clyde.
And they start putting this pressure on a little heavier. It looks like Bradshaw just trying to give Reed some room to operate.
Now they got him.
Double team.
And there's Watkins setting up Garland. And it scores. No basket. No basket. A foul before the shot.
It'll be a foul on Nix. He really showed some super speed there.
Misses Ray Meyer, cheering the DePaul Blue Demons.
There goes Bradshaw through. He had already beaten Reed. Miley, normally a real solid defensive player, let him go by, didn't get the shoulder over. Great shot by Bradshaw.
Well, that's an effort by Carl Nix.
Oh, it sure was.
Saved the basket.
Play.
And just a common foul. No basket, no free throw. DePaul plays it from the side, throws it in the backcourt. That's not a backcourt violation.
Well, what he called?
5 seconds.
He called 5 seconds on the throw, and it would not have been a backcourt situation.
Nobody touched the ball. It was the right call.
Right.
I think.
It was touch.
Was it touch?
That's what Hank Nichols, they're arguing about right now, that the ball was touched.
Well, if it was touched, then the clock automatically stops. You know, the five-second clock.
That's right. The five-second clock wouldn't have been a factor out there. They're going to correct the error, it looks like.
Good officials. I love this when officials do this.
Right. That was Hank Nichols stepping in there. Lenny Wirtz said, it's my mistake. Corrected it. Going the other way.
That seemed the right call. When you added it all up, that seemed to be the fairest call.
But Dick, no, not if someone didn't touch it. A five-second count goes if someone touches the ball
on either team.
DePaul leading 6-4. Garland. DePaul comes out with a hot hand. Garland has his second bucket. 8-4. 2.5 minutes play.
You notice they're clearing out, letting Larry Bird bring up the ball, which really takes away some of his other part of the game.
Nix down the bottom of the hole, 8-6. Carl Nix has four.
That was big for the Sycamores. They had to get him out of the gate fast. I say one way to fall to win this ball game, they have to cut Nix off.
Garland, three in a row for Gary Garland, the music man.
And that's beyond the defense. You don't really want to play a guy out there.
This is Meyer there. They have 14 grandchildren. The 15th one is on the way.
But Bradshaw's just eyeing Reed up coming down that court.
Bird playing the baseline now, trying to take Watkins inside. Great pass.
Oh!
And a dunk by Alex Gilbert. Foul against DePaul.
He went to two levels, and he got to one level, then went higher.
And here's again, when you try to double-team Larry Bird, coming over right there, he sees it, feels it, hits it into Gilbert, and there's that second level you're talking about, Al. He left that thing from outside the lane.
Bird with the assist, an unselfish star, Bird.
They call Gilbert Super J, or Super Jumper.
That's why I think Ray Meyer's idea of not trying to go over and help out on Bird is the only way to play him, because he'll hit the open man every time.
Gilbert's free throw miseries continue. He's hitting only 27% on the year. 10-8, DePaul with the ball and the lead. 3.5 minutes gone. Michigan State has beaten Penn. Garland, four in a row. And he's Gary Garland.
He's doing it against a great athlete. Carl Nix is a great athlete.
He leads the team in assists and in steals.
They call him the music man because his mother and his aunt, Dionne Warwick, of course, outstanding stars physically. Nix hits again. Foul on Mitchem. The ball underneath. Basket is good. And yes, good. Foul on Mitchem, his second.
Well, Carl Nix is getting out of that gate pretty good, too. There's Bill Hodges, a guy that's had a great year and certainly deserves being named Coach of the Year, what he's been able to do for the Sycamores.
Carl Nix is the son of a preacher man in Chicago.
He's a Baptist minister.
Little zone out of bounds. They'd like to get back to
Indiana State looking for a four-point play. Bird gets it. Larry Bird ties it at 12.
He has good control of his body, Billy, and he just stays in the air. He seems to fight for position all the time.
Right, he gets excellent position, and you really have to keep him off the offensive board.
Watkins Mitchem has it knocked away by Reed. He wasn't sure that was going to be a backcourt violation. Aguirre, 12-footer for the freshman Watkins. Boy, he'd really leave time that one. Foul against Aguirre, DePaul.
Aguirre tried to pump fake a couple of times there. Watkins looked pretty good on the leg. Good pass by Nix inside. Bird grabbed this one. You see his left thumb still giving him a little trouble. Now here's that offensive positioning you're talking about, Al. Totally in control of his body. Puts it back up with the left hand.
The ball's coming out with slight pressure man-to-man.
31 has been played.
Miley will give it up. He really doesn't want to handle the ball, but Nix can.
But what a pass by Larry Bird.
And Gilbert grabbed the rim and got away with it. It's still shaking up there.
Tied at 12. Aguirre off the mark. Gilbert high for the rebound.
Aguirre's going to find that Miley's a good defensive player. He's forcing some shots right now.
Nix traveled far sidelines. Turnover to Paul. As number 30, Bob Heaton comes in.
There you go, Larry Bird coming in, throwing it back with his left hand. I think we ought to point it. There's a super steal in there by Garland. Got to point out, Dick, that he is a left-handed individual, except when it comes to shooting that ball.
And as a right-handed baseball pitcher. We'll be back, tied at 12.
The crack of bats, the sweet, sticky smell of pine tar. It must be spring, because MLB 2005 is here. There's Sean Green going deep. Looking good, Adam Dunn. Get ready for the summer because MLB 2005 has everything you love about the game, as well as a nifty online mode so you can play folks across the country. Right, Eric Chavez? We'll take that as a yes. Ready for everyone. 9, 8, 9. Sports.
You don't hear this phone ringing?
Hello?
Hi, Mom.
Oh.
Where are you? You haven't called this house in 2 days. I'm so worried.
Rose, who is it?
Vegas.
I got married. Yeah, I got married, Mom.
I eloped.
But what in the world would make you do something like this?
$139 a week for any compact car at budget. For irresistible prices on irresistible cars, call 1-800-BUDGET-7 or visit budget.com.
When is cereal more than just breakfast? When it's grape nuts or shredded wheat. They have a healthy whole grain crunch that may help reduce your risk of heart disease. So start your day the Heart Smart way. Two healthy classics from Post. They're anything but ordinary.
Hey, life on a street stinks.
We need odor protection.
Only Odor Eaters has new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact.
Don't just fight foot odor and wetness.
Whack it with Odor Eaters Ultra Comfort insoles.
Whoa. Digital widescreen high-definition TVs with digital auto convergence and HD component video inputs, plus high-speed velocity scan modulation. Don't touch.
Hey, guys, check out the game in high def.
Sweet. Now pay no interest for 2 years or get 10% off all TVs $399 and up. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours. Best Buy.
Fresh, made to order. Sonic's got it, others don't. At Sonic, you won't find any microwaves around here, but you will find delicious all-beef burgers served with the freshest ingredients around and made after you order them, the way you like them. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
This is Relocation Central, also called Extended Stay America. It's sort of home between homes.
Very comfortable. Separate workspace, full kitchen with refrigerator, plenty of room, even a recliner. And the price is great.
So, I can take my time looking for a permanent place, or not. With all I get at Extended Stay America, why would I stay anywhere else?
Pick me out a winner, Bobby.
ESPN Classic presents Robert Redford and an all-star cast. The Natural, the movie, and an inside look from real sports legends. 8 Eastern, Sunday, April 4th, only on ESPN Classic.
How did these two guys get a show on ESPN Classic? By accident. Oh. Brace yourself for a new take on some old sports.
I know we're going to get fired.
Cheap Seats, 10 p.m. every Wednesday, only on ESPN Classic.
Indiana State trying to paint its way into the finals against Michigan State. Meanwhile, Curtis Watkins, the DePaul University's all-time top-scoring forward, appears to be working rather well on that bad knee. What do you think, Coach?
Yeah, so far he's working fine. He started off man-to-man on Larry Bird. The ball's mixed up with zones. I think he's going at 100%. We got to worry about the start of the second half when he sits down for 20 minutes.
Gary Garland's first miss. Bird with a rebound. Don't forget, Larry Bird, a great shooter, but he is also in the top five in the nation in rebounding.
Still man-to-man, but they're backing it in now. They're allowing Knicks to handle the ball a little bit.
Bird.
That's his game. Right from there. He's probably the best that ever played at the game from that distance at his height.
Bird has given Indiana State the lead. He has 6 points.
He's backing away from Mitchem.
Oh, my. James Mitchem. He hit those shots against UCLA.
Well, he wants that shot. Ray Meyer wants him to take that shot. That really makes it tough on Bird because he has to play so far away from the basket.
Miley to Bird. Over Watkins. He knew that was going in. He was fading back on defense as soon as it left his hand.
Perfect form. Shoots a lot like Rick Barrett.
Aguirre out of bounds, out of Aguirre's hands to Indiana State.
That's a great defensive play by Bird. We'll see his form on a jumper. Here's what you're talking about, Allie. Pushes him back in with a good ball fake. Solid fundamentally. Holds the ball above his head. Great release. Excellent rotation on the ball. The guy's incredible.
He gets super balance on his jump shot, Billy. He jumps straight up or maybe a little bit back.
Right, he's always squared up to the basket.
Guys left, our statistician has Bird with 8 and Garland with 8. And this game, quite in contrast to the first game, and a frenetic pace both sides. Short is Staley, rebound Mitchem.
Well, Staley and Heaton are both in the game. They may be better athletes than the guys that start.
Aguirre wants two, can't get it. He's missed three in a row. Bird with another rebound.
Mark Aguirre's pushing a little bit. That's a sign of a freshman. He needs his first basket, then he'll settle down.
Indiana State 16, DePaul 14. That's against Bird, charging Bird.
I like the call. What do you say, Billy?
Well, that's a call. That in my mind, I think it was a call on the defense. Watch him right here.
He puts his shoulder in, Billy.
Okay, watch him.
There he goes. There he goes into him with his shoulder.
Oh, no, he got position here. The man came down on him.
Eat some carrots, will you, for your eyesight.
I call it a double foul.
No. That's a good play that he has here. I don't think he gained an advantage.
That's a tough call. Bradshaw. Garland trying to tie it up. Does. Oh, was that a line drive kiss?
What a low trajectory on that shot. He played it off the backboard, the only way he could go in.
We played 7 minutes, and they're even at 16.
Got nobody hesitant in this game.
Larry Bird inside, and Bird controlling the game offensively.
Came around the low pick that time, Dick. Three on the left side, simple layup.
Has a set play, and he often does that, coming off that screen.
Garland and Bird matching point for point, each with 10. Watkins, he likes that baseline. Rebound Staley.
But Dickie came down on one leg that time, if you'll notice. He didn't have full balance.
Sycamore's lead by 2.
He got him posted up underneath there. Watkins is too small. Bird's going to post him up. They're going to force the ball into his own.
Oh, bad pass.
Turnover. Garland sets up Bradshaw.
Oh!
Bradshaw misses an easy two.
He dropped his head. He didn't know whether to dunk the ball or play it off the glass.
Yeah, sometimes the dunk is a problem child for the coach, isn't it? Traveling Bird.
That was definitely steps on Larry Bird. He had his mind made up to take it inside. Now, here he goes. He's got the screen right there. Staley is just staying in place. Set play coming off the low double post.
Mark Aguirre fell asleep on that. He should have picked up Larry Bird. Watkins was caught on the pick.
Ray Meyer looking for that miracle.
Aguirre getting inside now. There he is.
He's got his first two, 18-18, Aguirre's first bucket.
That's a smart play. He was taking a shot from outside, forced a little bit, finally posted up low.
He's 6'7", but with the size of his rear end, he plays about 6'10", if he gets you on his back.
Reed.
Oh, what a shot.
Does he ever miss?
Hey, what was so
so great about that? He took it right off the pass. He was on his way up as he caught the ball. You don't defense that.
I don't think he can get a high percentage of that shot. Now, that's a tough shot. Wow.
Watkins. And a foul against Watkins, who moved quickly. He had that good first step, but committed the foul.
And we talk about Bird on offense, but watch him defensively here. He drops down in. See, instead of going out with his man, he dropped down in and helped out, and they got good weak side defense. This is a solid team defensive ball club.
Both well coached.
A lot of people around the nation have heard, read about Larry Bird, seeing him for the first time, and how quickly he makes believers. Here he goes. Lays it off to Nix.
Oh.
Blocked by Aguirre, and Aguirre gets a foul.
Nix tried to do a double jackknife that time, hung up there, picked up the foul.
You know, one of the things I think is helping Nix in this ballgame, he's played against a lot of these Chicago kids. So it's not like being against people he's never seen before.
Nix at the line. He's made a big difference in this club. He transferred out of Indiana State after his freshman year, went to Gulf Coast Florida Community College, and now back with the Sycamores, much improved.
You know, Dick, Bob King told me that he promised Carl's mother and father that he would get a diploma. And they felt it was in his best interest to go away from junior college, even though it hurt their basketball team, which I think is a real credit to their program.
You know, it's a problem. Carl's mother and father couldn't come to the game because of the price of the plane ticket.
That's Indiana State's biggest lead, 4. DePaul is also led by 4. Approaching the midpoint, and that's a blocking penalty, 44 of Indiana State. Use the knee.
The more you see Gary Garland, the more you appreciate him.
You know, Aguirre, watching him in practice yesterday, he really doesn't like the practice. You know, he's one of those guys, Al, that you'd have had a hard time with, you know, especially being a freshman. I bet you the poor kid's ears would be off.
I never had a hard time with it with a ball player. They always had hard times with me.
He's getting position down there, using his bulk now.
Garland, way outside. Not there, and that was Bird who tipped it into the corner. Reed. Nix
has blocked.
Way off the mark. Aguirre, Garland.
Oh, beautiful.
Beautiful passing. Mitchem gets the bucket. Don't you love to see that kind of teamwork?
Team play. You know, Mitchem really beat UCLA because I don't think he could hit that good from the outside. But he's out of the gate fast again, and this time he scored 4 points already from the outside.
A real key to me early in the game is the fact that Steve Reed's been able to get the ball up court rather easily.
Nix traveled, and at the halfway mark, 9:58 left in the first half, Indiana State leads by a basket, and we have a timeout.
There's that beautiful dump off right inside. Bradshaw over to Mitchem, little fake, and there's the shot you're talking about, Al, but it looks like he has confidence in it.
And DePaul will have the ball when we return, needing a basket to tie.
Quick, in the top 5 water polo players in the world. Okay, how about 1? Yeah. I didn't start playing water polo to get famous. And the same goes for being a biology major. I like working in protein chemistry. Quick, in the top 5 protein chemists in the world.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Inside every can of Minwax is the secret to enhancing wood's natural beauty. Minwax rich wood stains and long-lasting protective finishes make it easy to turn any house into a beautiful home. Minwax, making wood beautiful for 100 years.
Ugh, my feet ache.
They don't smell so great either.
Only Odorators Plus Arch Support insoles have new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact. Revives tired feet.
Give foot ache and odor the boot with Odorators Plus.
John Wooden, Rick Pitino, two legendary coaches, back to back. Sports Century, John Wooden, premieres at 8 p.m. Monday, followed by the premiere of Sports Century, Rick Pitino at 8:30, only on ESPN Classic.
What if you could go back in time?
You are watching what greatness is all about.
One unforgettable game started it all. Now, 25 years later, 25 straight hours, Magic versus Bird, all day today on ESPN Classic.
It doesn't come from a store or grow old on a shelf. The technology that matters only comes direct from Dell. Just tell Dell about you and what you want from technology. Whether it's a PC or the gear to get more out of it, we'll make sure they fit your life and fit your budget even better. Because after 20 years, there's a reason Dell's the right way to buy. We only bring the right technology direct to you. Right now, this Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor is just $499 after mail-in rebate. Plus, you'll get a free CD burner and a free memory upgrade. Notebooks start at $699. If you want someone to walk you through everything in plain English, just call. Or point and click your way through easy online menus at dell.com/TV. Either way, you're not just getting a PC. You're getting a Dell. And a smarter way, you won't find in any store. Easy as Dell. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
They're already giving the Yankees the American League pennant, but Milwaukee, Boston, and others say, just wait and see. First game, Brewers at New York, and the Phils will play in St. Louis. You'll see Pete Rose in a Philly uniform for the first time. That's a couple of weeks away, the start of our coverage of Major League Baseball. Inside, Aguirre. Bradshaw. Rebound to Gilbert. 22-20. Indiana State with the ball and the lead. 9:30 remaining in this first half.
Zone defense, Dick.
It was Bradshaw who made the steal and then forced the foul off next.
During that timeout, of course, Ray Meyer changing his defense out, going to his zone for the first time with the exception of the out-of-bounds situation.
Knicks goes out, and Bob Heaton, number 30, who has been the star in a couple of big Indiana State wins this year, is in. It was Heaton who made the little left-hander to beat Arkansas, and he also made a 50-footer against New Mexico State to send that game in overtime in Las Cruces, and Indiana State eventually won.
Larry Bird fouled out of that game before the end of it.
Bradshaw dumping to Garland. Jerry Garland ties it up at 22. He has a dozen.
Boy, he's hitting them, but those are long shots out there, and you have to feel that they've got to get their inside game going some.
Well, we got a tie with 9 minutes to go.
Still in the zone, 2-3 zone.
Bob Heaton off the mark. Followed in by Alex Gilbert,
and Bird kept it alive.
Maley and Gilbert do all their scoring from 3 feet around the basket.
Mitchem. Oh, he hits again. Now, Heaton and Mitchem were teammates at Denver for 2 years. Their coach, Al Harden, is here. The Denver de-emphasizing his program. Those were his kids. He said, what a unique position. I've got one of my former players with DePaul, the other with Indiana State. I can't lose.
And Ray Meyer goes back to man-to-man. Heaton missed Bird that time. He had position.
Deflected by Bradshaw. Pass back to Bradshaw. Oh. And a foul on Bradshaw. Reed got back to shut him off.
Steve Reed got there in time. Got a position.
Now Bradshaw should have pulled up on that one because he had some people coming down in the lane.
Pretty hard with that speed. Look how fast it's going, Billy.
Well, here's Reed right here coming down in position. Draws the charge. He really didn't have the lane.
I agree with Al McGuire, though, once again. That should be just a ball out of bounds and not a foul to the man who charged. Maybe it would discourage some of that kind of defense, a fall-down defense. Tied at 24, turned over. Garland again, the man on the spot, the demon.
He tried to loop the ball into Gilbert that time.
Boy, they're getting a good screen.
Foul on 30, Heaton. It was not a shot.
Here's a case where they're setting up.
36 years of age, coach of the year in almost every balloting at the end of the season.
He was the best man at Rick Mount's wedding, and at his wedding, Rick Mount was the best man. They both come from Lebanon.
Don't forget, gentlemen, most valuable player, that school receives $1,000 from Gillette Razor Company. We'll announce that later in the game. Aguirre rattles one in to give DePaul the lead, 26-24. Wire is averaging 24 points a game.
Time to get the ball to Larry.
There he is, and there it is. Larry Bird ties it at 26. He has 14.
You you notice how when he came down, he headed right in for the offensive rebound. Thought it was off a little bit.
He's really a terrific young guy.
Watkins, quick move and scores. Curtis Watkins playing on that sore knee gives DePaul the two-point lead.
These are two fine college basketball teams we're looking at right now. They play it all the game very well.
Oh! Hey. Great assist by Reed, and it's tied at 28.
Just a touch pass by Bird. Reed to Bird, Gilbert.
And those two fellows will do all their scoring again within 3 feet of the basket. Gilbert and Miley.
Aguirre, Mitchem, and Bradshaw. Mitchem over Bird. He has had three in a row.
He's made me a believer. I knocked his outside shooting the first game. I apologize to the whole United States.
It's not that big a deal.
Well, he's from Albuquerque, New Mexico, too.
Falling on Bird. Turnover to DePaul.
Bird walking. Ray Meyer wants a timeout. I don't know why. It looks like he's in pretty good shape.
No, he wanted a technical foul.
Oh, technical. What happened here? Bird threw the ball down. But it was just a pass to the referee. Here he goes. Pump fake. Steps in. Now watch him go for the rebound. Oh, we missed him a little bit there. But there he is, right under the basket.
That's a good point, Tony. He is a complete player. He's not just a shooter. Garland misses on his knifing attempt through that defense. And here comes Indiana State trailing by two.
He's the weak side guard. He cuts off the high pivot. He was free.
That's two.
You're right. Larry Bird, All-American.
Well, if you're Ray Meyer sitting over there, Al, you got to start saying to yourself, hey, we're going to have to deny him the pass. Move him out a little further because he's getting out there and touching it from 18 feet.
Well, the game's going good. I don't think anyone's going to make any major changes right now. It's 30-30, and it's 5 minutes and 30 seconds left. Yep.
Ball on Heaton.
Too much hands on the cut from the weak side by Gary Garland going to the strong side of the court. Whatever side the ball's on is called the strong side of the court. You run a string from one basket to the other.
Interesting point, and it reflects what kind of game this is, gentlemen. The game has been tied 11 times already. It's tied now at 30.
There's Larry Bird again, stepping out, helping out on defense.
Mark looking for that post position.
Nice move by Mitchem, but Bird was there.
Good defense, man-to-man by Indiana State.
Aguirre. 30 DePaul.
He was on my team in two high school games this year that played in New England in May. He really made me a good coach.
Back to the zone again. They're trying to figure out some way to slow Bird down.
Knicks deflected out of bounds by Aguirre. And again, the quickness of the DePaul defense. Timeout. Beautiful special events center on the campus of the University of Utah. And we've got a beautiful game.
When is cereal more than just breakfast? When it's grape nuts or shredded wheat. They have a healthy whole grain crunch that may help reduce your risk of heart disease. So start your day the Heart Smart way. Two healthy classics from Post. They're anything but ordinary.
Feel really good riding with Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Over a million people understand its strength. It can give you new energy, a new outlook, and an entirely new shape. This is Bowflex Power Rod technology. And it can only be found on genuine Bowflex equipment, like the new Bowflex Extreme. Designed by Nautilus to make losing weight and building muscle more effective than ever. Now you can get the results you want, the exercises you need, all at an affordable price. You've never seen this Bowflex before. Call 1-800-261-7714 now and get the new Bowflex Extreme with no money down and just $19 a month. Getting a high-performance body has never been more affordable. All it takes is a plan, a commitment, and a proven tool that makes getting results so easy. When you're ready to get in shape, look for real Bowflex Power Rod technology and the new Bowflex Extreme. We've won the confidence of over a million people because we mean what we say. We live up to our promises, and ultimately, we deliver results. Women and men of all ages are feeling better, performing better, and looking better with one simple workout done 20 minutes a day, three times a week. Call and find out what Bowflex's Power Rod technology can do for you. All our machines come with a 100% satisfaction guarantee. In fact, Bowflex has several new models for you to see, many backed by a 10-year warranty. Now you can own your very own Bowflex, like the new Extreme, for no money down and only $19 a month. The Bowflex Extreme is not available in stores. You know you're ready. It's time to let Bowflex help you get there. Call now to get a great deal on the professional quality Extreme. Now, just $19 a month.
Inside, Staley. Bird tips it in. He's everywhere.
You can't leave him. He's getting too open in this ball game. You better just glue yourself to it.
18 for Bird already, and the game is tied for the 12th time. Bradshaw follows it in.
Good rebound.
Clyde Bradshaw inside to give DePaul a 34-32 lead.
Ball sitting in the 2-3 zone.
Reed's first shot is there. Nope. They give him room, and Steve Reed connects.
He can fill it up. He sacrifices himself for the team.
You know what's a good thing about all the Indiana State University players is that they don't try to do more than they're capable of.
Aguirre to Watkins. Fine interior passing. And Bird looking for the foul.
That's a good no-call. He jumped in a little late.
36-34, DePaul with 3.5 minutes left, first half.
Look at that zone, it's really shaded over on Bird's side now.
Fix, Aguirre, stolen, and then taken away as Watkins held his ground.
Hot potato.
Ray Meyer checks the clock, 3:18 left, first half.
Boy, Aguirre sets a big screen up there in that foul line. Guys come off of him like a tank.
Garland has it knocked away. Watkins picks up the loose ball. He is lightning.
Important to get it to Larry Bird now, this time down to court. Watch how the zone is shifting over. See, they're even saying, he's on your side. Get over there.
4 point DePaul lead, 2:45 left.
They'll look for Bird this time.
That's not too far out there. It's unbelievable, his range.
Reed, connects. Steve Reed.
Big shot.
He's the quarterback of the team. One of the only four players out there directly out of high school. Two in junior college and two in transfer. Indiana State.
Pass and a holding foul against Staley, 44 of Indiana State. Staley's second foul, 1-1 in effect for DePaul.
Here we see Watkins on the outside. Ball kind of got away from everybody. Look at him hang time in the air, laid it up beautiful.
Notice how he favors his left leg, Billy, coming down.
Right.
Lands completely on his right.
He did that on his jumper also.
Yeah, an injury stays in your head longer than it stays in your body. Did that make sense?
Yeah, I think it definitely does. He was dragging that leg yesterday.
His first free throw, and he misses the front end of 1-1. Indiana State a chance to tie. Bird.
Oh, what a touch.
Oh, danced it on the rim and dropped it in. We're even at 38. Bird has 20 points.
Yep. He anticipated the block and just put it up a little bit higher. What a touch.
That ball landed so soft, like a butterfly landing on soft feet.
Good defense by Knicks.
14 times this game has been tied. Each team has pulled ahead by only four, their biggest margin.
Either one of these clubs would be a great representative in the final. Here's that zone. They're going with a little more. Now it's a 2-1-2.
Knicks inside. Nice pass at 40. Brad Miley has his first bucket.
Neither team can figure out the secret to stop the other.
Watkins got away with a travel and scores.
He walked.
Well, terrific shot off balance there.
40 to 40.
We got ourselves a bond burner.
Knicks. Rebound. Mitchem foul on 42 Gilbert. The 1979 NCAA basketball championship program. It's a memento you'll treasure. Exclusive information on the Final Four, tournament records, plus plenty of photos, features, much more contained in this collector's issue. Send a check or money order for $4 to NCAA program, box 1979, Lexington, Kentucky, 40594. Appreciating message furnished by the NCAA.
Dick, that foul was on Watkins. Of course, Larry Bird gets that tough offensive rebounding position. Tough to keep him out of there.
And Bird gives Indiana State the lead, 41-40. Looking for his 22nd point of this half.
He called it off. He knew it as soon as he released it.
Well, with a minute 10, Watkins gives
Demons
the lead. No whistle. 42-41. Final minute, first half. A great first half as Reed gives Indiana State the lead. Three in a row from outside 20 for Reed. A sophomore.
As I told you earlier, he's an excellent shooter. He's the glue that keeps this team together. He sacrifices himself offensively.
Everybody coming off that high screen by Aguirre, but nobody getting it inside yet.
Garland with 28. Garland open. Bird rebounds. Indiana State has the lead. Can add two more to its total.
They'll play for one shot, obviously.
And they're going for one.
There's the man to shoot it. Well, back to Bird. Great pass. Oh, what a play.
Brad Miley.
Good ball, has to hurry.
You got to get it up, Garland. Get it up.
And that's the end of the first half. At the intermission, Larry Bird and the Indiana State Sycamores. Bird leading the way with 23 points. Lead DePaul University. A great show by a great All-American and a marvelous 20 minutes of basketball. Indiana State leaves the court leading DePaul by three.
There are two sides to me. The all-conference catcher side, that's my tough side. And the side of me studying for a career in marine mammal rescue, that's my soft side. I'm finding I really need both sides to be the whole person that I want to be.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
My job keeps me hopping and on the road all the time, so I know hotels. And that's why I stay at Extended Stay America. I'm not cramped. It's value. I get a full kitchen so I can cook my own meals. There's a place where I can do a little work, even a recliner where I can just relax. And check out the price.
Everything I need, great price. That's real value.
And I get it at Extended Stay America. Why would I stay anywhere else?
Pick it up, Stinky.
Me? You got no stamina.
Only Odor Eaters has new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact.
Get tough with foot odor.
Get Odor Eaters Ultra Durable Insoles.
Kick off this year's baseball season with some of the greatest games from the 2003 playoffs. The upsets, the rivalries, and destiny snatched away. Plus,
the curse of the Bambino will never go away.
An ESPN original documentary on the curses hanging over the Cubs and the Red Sox.
It's never over until it's really over.
The greatest games from the 2003 playoffs, all day Sunday, April 4th. Then at 7 p.m., the Babe and the Billy Goat reverse the curse. Only on ESPN Classic.
I'm Dr. Greg Cinamone, and no offense to casual dieters, but if you only want to lose 5 to 10 pounds, then Cortislim is not for you. Cortislim is the weight loss capsules created by my associate, Dr. Talbot, for people who are disgusted with diets and quickly want to lose 15 pounds or more. Dr. Talbot's hormone research has been featured in Ladies Home Journal, Psychology Today, and Red Book. The conclusion? It's not your fault that you're overweight. Stress causes you to overproduce a fat-retaining hormone called cortisol, and it directs fat to be stored in cells around your tummy, thighs, and stomach. Non-prescription Cortislim controls cortisol, so you release those excess pounds. And Cortislim stifles your appetite while enhancing your metabolism, so you eat less as you burn calories and shed inches. Drop 15 to 50 pounds with Cortislim.
Call 1-800-320-4338. That's 1-800-320-4338. 1-800-320-4338.
With a lot of hoopla and publicity, the NCAA crowns their Division I basketball champion, but they award a lot of championships in other sports also. Let's take a moment now to salute our other NCAA champions. Football, Division I AA, Florida A&M. Division II, Eastern Illinois, Baldwin-Wallace champions, Division III. In soccer, Divisions I, II, and III, they are USF, Seattle Pacific, and Lock Haven State, respectively. Indoor track champions, Villanova. In water polo, Stanford. Colorado, the champions, Division I skiing. In cross country, our three divisional champs, Texas, El Paso, Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo, and North Central. In wrestling, Division I, Iowa State wound up with the championship. Cal State Bakersfield took it for Division II, Trenton State for Division III. In swimming, Cal State Northridge and Johns Hopkins walk away with honors, while in basketball, Division II champions North Alabama and Division III people from North Park. We salute all of those champions. And speaking of champions, last night in Charlotte, North Carolina, there was a McDonald's High School All-America Classic played among a lot of blue chippers coming out of high school. It was an assemblage of some great talent. For highlights of that ball game, we get this report now from Larry Sacknoff.
Last night in Charlotte, the largest crowd to ever watch a prep game in North Carolina, 11,666, turned out to watch the College Stars of Tomorrow in the McDonald's All-American game. Some of the more highly publicized players were Dominic Wilkins, watching Magic Irvin Johnson there, 7'3 Ralph Sampson of Harrisonburg, Virginia, John Paxton of Kettering, Ohio, and Antoine Carr of Wichita, Kansas. Let's take a look at some of these players. East squad won it 106-105 in overtime. They've all got that outside shot. That's Horace Owens out of Philadelphia swishing it through. Dirk Minifield out of Lexington, Kentucky, has decided to stay in that state, play his college ball at Kentucky. He's got that outside shot, doesn't he? Watch John Paxton. He's the brother of Dayton star Jim Paxton. He's going to go to Notre Dame, play for Digger Phelps. Isaiah Thomas likes to go to the hoop. The heck with that outside shot. John Paxton to Ricky Ross to Tim Andre. All these guys know how to pass the ball around. Andre, by the way, is 6'11". He's also going to go to Notre Dame and play for Digger. Ralph Sampson, 7'3", highly recruited, the most highly recruited athlete in the country right now. He's number 33. He's devastating. He blocked 10 shots last night, had 11 rebounds, and I tell you, he can do it all underneath that hoop. He can even start the fast break for you. Watch this. He's going to get that outlet pass out to Dominic Wilkins, who's going to go in for that hoop, and nobody's going to stop him right there. Now, all of these guys like to slam dunk, and don't forget, they're only in high school. They're not your college stars yet or your pros. Look at that. They can go to that hoop and just slam it right through. Wilkins, Carr, Darren Day, they can all do it, and they do it pretty well, don't they? Now, Darren Day of the West squad scored 22 points, and because of that, he was voted the most valuable player of that game, and for that, he received the John Wooden Award. As you are watching the Stars of Tomorrow, you'll be seeing him on college basketball and eventually in the pros. I'm Larry Sacknoff for NBC Sports.
It's 45-42 at the half. Indiana State out in front of DePaul. This one close as expected. Two teams going for the right to meet Michigan State on Monday night. Larry Bird has 23 first half points, but DePaul countering it very well with good balance. For a look at the first half, let's go cross court. Dick Enberg, Al McGuire.
Now we have the first unfinished business, Brian. Want to say to Big House Gaines down there at Winston-Salem, he has more career victories than does Ray Meyer, although the statistics are broken down sometimes in divisions. We didn't mean to slight a great coach, had a great pupil in Earl Monroe. Another unfinished business, we understand the Knicks will be here on Monday night if Indiana State wins.
The Reverend had work to do tomorrow. It's Sunday. And so they're going to come out if Indiana State wins for the finals.
All right, so much for that. We saw an exciting offensive first half, very few mistakes, great shooting, three-point Indiana State lead, and Larry Bird continues to just be beyond description.
Fight. He's just so good. He makes everyone around him good. That's how you can tell a good ball player. He's unselfish. He has the whole game. If there's any weakness, it's maybe a little bit slower foot. But I doubt he even has that.
You know, there are five men in basketball history who have scored more points than Larry Bird, and all of them have their name or some memento in the Hall of Fame in Springfield, Massachusetts. I think you're going to enjoy a flashback now of some of the great names enshrined.
The Hall of Fame in Springfield, Massachusetts traces the history of the sport invented by Dr. James Naismith and includes memorabilia and film of the game's greatest players.
Naismith was faced with the fact that 18 fellows didn't particularly like physical training exercised by the numbers. They wanted to play a competitive game. There was no indoor competitive game at the time, so he decided he needed a couple of boxes about 18 inches square, and he asked the janitor to get a couple of those. The janitor didn't have them, but he had a couple of peach baskets, and 144 nations later and about 80 years, you have basketball. As the game developed, it would be impossible to imagine how they did shoot. Probably they shot one hand. But we do know the coaches were convinced the best shot of all was a two-handed shot. Of course, Paul Arizin was considered one of the first great jump shooters. Joe Foulkes out of Kentucky was one of the most amazing scorers and the first man to score over 60 points in a game, unheard of in 1947. Now, there have been other great jump shooters, and present-day shooters are among the most deadly shooters that you would find. Probably one of the great changes in the game of basketball is the fact that all of today's players are such great shooters.
Seven men will be inducted into the Hall of Fame on April 30th, among them five coaches and a referee.
The only player inducted this year will be Wilt Chamberlain, the historical NBA All-Star. Think of all of his records. Over 31,000 points scored. Over 30 points a game average. Played over 1,000 games in over 47,000 minutes and never fouled out of one game. Over 23,000 rebounds. And 55 in one game. And the 55 he got in one game was against his great rival, Bill Russell, also a Hall of Famer. Wilt Chamberlain certainly must be considered the greatest offensive player in the history of the game of basketball.
Wilt's picture will join the others in the honor court. It's a gallery of greats in a game that's come a long way from what Dr. Naismith had in mind.
We've got a good second half going, second ball game going, rather. Indiana State out in front of DePaul, 45-42. Let's go back to Dick and the coach.
Well, that's an understatement, Brian. A great first half of shooting. And, coach, you look at those statistics. What was your first comment?
Oh, my God. To shoot 75%, Indiana State at 21-28. DePaul should be 12 points ahead with their shooting. They're shooting 60%, 21-35. Nobody's in foul trouble. That's what's going to make it a terrific game. The most anyone has is two. I don't think either coach is going to change their style.
No, and he won't do something to stop Bird with 23 points?
No, I think they're happy the way the game's going. The game was really a tie. It went up 3 points at the very end of the ball game. It looks to me like a white knuckler.
Well, that's the kind of game that this tournament is famous for. It was not the case in the first game. The only white knuckles were those of the Penn players, coaches, and fans. It was all Michigan State. They've earned a berth in the finals.
The first game was certainly not a white knuckler. The Michigan State Spartans came into this one looking to beat Pennsylvania, but nobody ever dreamed they'd do what they did to Penn. They rattled off 9 unanswered points in the first half at one stretch, 19 at another stretch. And as for the Penn Quakers, well, not a lot was going right. They couldn't get the ball down in the hole. When they did come up with it, they managed to throw it away. And for Bob Weinauer on the sidelines, it was a long day for him and his Penn Quakers. The only anxious moment the Spartans had came when an injury occurred to Terry Donnelly. The Spartans playing their usual running game. Watch this one. Magic Johnson comes across, feeds off to Donnelly, but when he goes up, he loses his legs off from under him, and the agony in his face tells the complete story. He sat out the rest of the half, but came back in the second half to play. By that time, Michigan State had it well salted away, thanks to Gregory Kelser. He tossed in 28 points. Michigan State was up 50-17 at the half. The only reason Penn made it respectable was because they tossed in 50 second-half points, Bobby Willis getting two of them right there. But the game was long since out of question. Irvin Johnson tossing in two of his 29 from the corner. Between them, Kelser and Johnson, 57 points. The final, Michigan State 101, Penn 67. The Spartans move on into Monday night's final. And that's the end of our Pro Keds basketball report. We'll be back right after this message.
Hey, life on a street stinks.
We need odor protection.
Only Odor Eaters has new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact.
Don't just fight foot odor and wetness.
Whack it with Odor Eaters Ultra Comfort Insoles.
Sometimes in the face of insurmountable odds, unlikely heroes are born. As precious seconds ticked away, you took an impossible amount of data and turned it into something impossibly good. You have the new Microsoft Office system. Victory is yours.
Well, old Paul Bunyan must be spinning in his pine box. When a man takes to warming his bones with a counterfeit fire, how far away can he be from succumbing to electric razors and leaf blowers and pleated pants? America, is that really you?
I decided to make some serious changes. Now, chicken McNuggets are made with white meat. If they can change for the better, so can I.
I'm loving it. Right now, there's $350 billion in tax cuts out there. It's like this big, freshly baked pie. And our job at H&R Block is to get you the biggest slice possible.
Get the maximum refund or it's free. Another advantage of H&R Block.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship, East and West Regional Semifinals, begin Saturday at noon Eastern on ESPN.
What if you could go back in time?
You are watching what greatness is all about.
One unforgettable game started it all. Now, 25 years later, 25 straight hours, Magic versus Bird, all day today on ESPN Classic.
Sellout crowd of 15,000 fans on the campus of the University of Utah. Special Events Center ready for the second half. First half shooting statistics were incredible. As you could see, 75% for Indiana State, 60% for DePaul. And Larry Bird, what do you think he shot individually, Al?
I think an unbelievable 83%.
He just made another. He was 11 for 12, 92% the first half.
He broke the calculator.
That's the biggest lead of the game by either team. 5 points, Indiana State. Garland off the mark, and Bird rebounds. He had 7 rebounds and 5 assists to go with his 23 points in the first half.
I think if you're DePaul, you're going to have to get that ball inside to Aguirre in the second half. They counted on the long-range bomb in the first half. It went in, but they're not getting to the inside game.
Missed the shot, but he was fouled, and that explains part of it all.
Of course, it won't count as an attempt here. Here he is moving around constantly looking for offensive position. Watkins too late getting there. There's the beautiful soft touch inside. That was the basket right before this one.
Third foul on Watkins. Bird now needs only 12 points to become the number 5 scorer in college basketball history. Top 4, Pete Maravich, Freeman Williams, the Big O, Oscar Robertson, the Big E, Elvin Hayes, and Bird could be number 5, pass Otis Birdsong today. He needs now just a handful of buckets.
Big basket here for DePaul. They've got to get this one. Miley doing a big job on Aguirre. They're really pushing each other inside.
I'm sure Ray Meyer wants to get it into the young freshman. He's got to be patient.
There's Aguirre. Oh, a tough turnaround, 15-footer. 49-44. 1 minute gone, second half.
That was the biggest basket for DePaul so far this game. But still, Al, they're not getting it in there easy. You know, they're making tough baskets. They'll create some turnovers soon. There goes Bird again off the low screen.
They got a push in the back from Watkins, and that'll be his fourth foul. Curtis Watkins now saddled with four.
I think Gary Garland got him, and here's where Ray Meyer's going to have to make a switch on defense.
They'll put Mitchem on Bird.
Yeah, got to make the switch. See, Bird is so tough to handle because you try to deny him the ball. He steps out for the jumper. He moves in and post, then he comes over the screen. Just keeps moving.
Oh, right down the bottom of the hole, and that was shot downward by Alex Gilbert.
He was about a half a foot above the rim to shut it down.
8 points for Gilbert.
Now we're looking for Ray Meyer to call a timeout here if he can't get something started. The game getting away from him early in the second half.
Indiana State with its biggest lead, 7 points. He played less than 2 minutes. Aguirre.
There it is.
Mark Aguirre, he now has 10.
Trying to create some turnovers. They're picking up a little bit stronger up court now. They're in a 1-2-2 press, trap press, with Mitchell playing a one-man zone in the back.
Reed. Miley.
Oh, big pass.
Brad Miley takes it to the hoop, and he has four. They shot 75% in the first half, and they haven't missed a shot in the second half. Garland, Bird, rebound.
Garland was hitting that jumper in the first half. Not there, and not getting into their offense at all. Here's Mitchem on Bird.
Larry Bird, a phenomenal display.
I've watched him a couple of times. It's unbelievable. He hits that shot like he hit a layup.
There's the timeout.
Timeout to Paul. Larry Bird with 29 points has sparked the Sycamores into their biggest lead of the game. A 9-point advantage, 17 minutes left.
Check it out.
Skaters.
Whatever.
Man, in a perfect world, you could skate wherever you want.
Yeah.
And Tony Hawk would be there. And he'd be this milkman, and he'd give us all the Hershey's milkshakes we could drink.
That'd be perfect.
Nah. It'd be perfect if everybody had a mohawk.
When is cereal more than just breakfast? When it's grape nuts or shredded wheat. They have a healthy whole grain crunch that may help reduce your risk of heart disease. So start your day the Heart Smart way. Two healthy classics from Post. They're anything but ordinary.
Ugh, my feet ache.
Ugh, they don't smell so great either.
Only Odor Eaters Plus Art Support insoles have new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact. Revives tired feet.
Give foot ache and odor the boot with Odor Eaters Plus.
I pull for the underdog.
Come on!
I pray, curse, cry. I will drop down on my knees and beg for a three-pointer from half court.
Play your way to the NCAA Final Four with Singular. You can be entered weekly for a trip for two every time you send and receive a text, instant, or a multimedia message. And every time you download games and ringtones. The more you do, the better your chances.
I call it the
yeah, baby
plan.
Play your way to the NCAA Final Four. Another way Singular fits you best.
It's big enough to put him in back and not smell his breath.
Introducing the 2004 Isuzu Ascender.
First time I drove it, I was like, that hill used to be steep.
Its inline six is more powerful than most V8s. A price starting at just $25,700 and backed by one terrific warranty.
7 years. Seven people years.
The new Isuzu Ascender. Spend less. Go farther.
Baseball's back. Relive the greatest games from the 2003 playoffs, Sunday, April 4th.
John Wooden.
He's really General Patton underneath it all.
Rick Pitino.
He doesn't think small time. He thinks very, very big.
Two legendary coaches. Two Sports Century World premieres Monday, back to back. From the old school.
He could make a player cry.
And he never swore. To the new school.
You don't say no to Rick Pitino.
Sports Century, John Wooden, premieres at 8 p.m. Monday, followed by the premiere of Sports Century, Rick Pitino at 8:30, only on ESPN Classic.
Ray Meyer looking a bit more stern as he sees that Indiana State team dominate that just can't be stopped.
Well, what he said in the huddle most likely was not to lose your composure. Indiana State has to go into a drought soon. The way they've been playing offensively, it's a believe it or not quickly thing.
You know what's amazed me? That nobody has played Larry Bird a boxing one throughout this entire playoff series. He needs some help playing against him.
That's only a second miss of this game. Bird is going after Bill Walton's Final Four record of 44 points. Watkins is short. And with playing just five men, DePaul, fatigue may be a factor. Shots are short. Nix. No car, no foul. Gilbert makes it 57-46.
Courage by Watkins.
And a real good athletic ability on the part of Nix to be able to stop on the dime.
You know, DePaul, I've seen them down a few times. They don't lose their composure.
They're going inside, and I think that's the smart move.
Mitchem outside, can't hit. Garland goes inside and banks it home.
He's a player. He's not only a player, he's an outstanding player.
You know, they haven't been able to turn the ball over in the backcourt yet with a steal. That's something that was the real key to this ball game, and that's been handled well so far.
Rebound taken off by Watkins. Three on one to DePaul. Aguirre.
Oh, steal.
Boy, that should have been a foul, though. Reed got a piece of him at the same time. And who is that that went?
Larry Bird.
Larry Bird.
He flew into the stands.
He's okay.
He's a pretty tough kid. I watched him try to handle him on a physical ball game back in Cincinnati. He can handle that, too. Here you go, coming down.
Well, he got the ball.
He got the ball, had a little bit of the hand. There goes Bird through the stand.
Indiana State might be in that drought I was talking about. You just can't stay hot for the whole game.
Al, you owe me $5. You said if he hit another one, you were going to give me $5.
I heard it. Mitchell,
I'm a believer. I'm a believer in Mitchell.
Yeah, but pay me the $5.
Mitchell, that'll be a real
Mitchell
story. 57-50, Indiana State. Played only 4 minutes.
Nice.
Mitchem with a block, but Bird is there again. Larry Bird with 31. He needs only 6 more to pass Birdsong and be number 5 all time.
He's ambidextrous. He writes and eats left-handed. He shoots basketball and cool right-handed.
Mitchem again. Not there. Watkins.
Well, he's battling now. He forgot the leg.
Watkins, and the foul is on Bird. Bird tried to influence on the call, and he really hadn't blocked him off.
Larry got there a little bit late on that one. Here he comes down the other end. Now watch him, constantly moving. People are leaving him. I don't understand. When you've got a responsibility to guard him, you better stay with him, even if you've got to help out with somebody else, because he's going to be in position.
One of his biggest assets, he goes to the offensive board, Bill. You said that earlier.
Yeah, super.
Gary Garland can't connect. Gilbert high for the rebound, a great leaper.
Boy, he's a sky hook, that guy.
Oh, good defensive move. And
Reed loses it out of bounds. One of the few turnovers in this game.
Garland set that one up down the other end. Reed got by him.
You can't fool around the pool.
Timeout, Indiana State. We played 5 minutes and 5 seconds of the second half, and the score, Sycamores 59, Demons 50.
You've got to step up. Close out all of the pressure. Trust everything you've been taught. And just believe you can do it. You know, my first day on the job sure felt familiar.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
You know the feeling. Every guy's had it. You're unbeatable, unstoppable. You got that walking on water feeling. You look, they smile. You win, they go home. Gillette. It's It's the feeling you get every day with the world's best shave, Mach 3 Turbo. It's like having an angel by your side. Every move is smooth. Every word is cool. I never want to lose that feeling.
It's not the glamour that excites me, that thrills and delights me. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. When you're in my arms and I freeze.
With over 500 hotels nationwide, we're never far away. Unless, of course, you'd like us to be. Courtyard, our rooms were made for you.
Free incoming calling plans from Nextel. Get instant walkie-talkie to connect in under a second. And get free incoming calls. Fast and free, starting at $49.99 a month. Get it done fast and free. Call 800-6-NEXTEL to shop or find a Nextel store.
Baseball's back. Now relive the greatest games from the 2003 playoffs. Plus the story behind the curse of the Babe and the Billy Goat. All day Sunday, April 4th. Then at 7 p.m., the ESPN original documentary. Only on ESPN Classic.
What if you could go back in time? One unforgettable game started it all. Now, 25 years later, 25 straight hours. Magic versus Bird, all day today on ESPN Classic.
I'm Dr. Greg Cinnamone, and no offense to casual dieters, but if you only want to lose 5 to 10 pounds, then Cortislim is not for you. Cortislim is the weight loss capsules created by my associate, Dr. Talbot, for people who are disgusted with diets and quickly want to lose 15 pounds or more. Dr. Talbot's hormone research has been featured in Ladies Home Journal, Psychology Today, and Red Book. The conclusion? It's not your fault that you're overweight. Stress causes you to overproduce a fat-retaining hormone called cortisol, and it directs fat to be stored in cells around your tummy, thighs, and stomach. Non-prescription Cortislim controls cortisol, so you release those excess pounds. And Cortislim stifles your appetite while enhancing your metabolism, so you eat less as you burn calories and shed inches. Drop 15 to 50 pounds with Cortislim.
Call 1-800-320-4338. That's 1-800-320-4338. 1-800-320-4338.
Incredible as it may be, with the shooting in the first half, both teams are shooting better in the second half. Indiana State 6-for-7, DePaul 6-for-9. Bob Heaton in the game. Another very subtle but excellent substitution by Bill Hodges. Wanted to keep fresh people out there. Reed was wearing down.
Foul on number 40, Brad Miley of Indiana State, his first.
Mark Aguirre, fighting for a post position, is forcing himself too high. He has to settle in lower and catch Miley on his rear end.
That is the official game statistics. Indiana State 73% of the game. Lead by 9, 59-50.
At halftime, DePaul had 7 rebounds because there were no rebounds.
There's Aguirre. He's in position.
Ooh, foul by Gilbert. Gilbert. Great leaper, and he denied the 2 points by Aguirre.
Well, he's a high rise.
I don't know if we saw this one, but Aguirre used his elbow to knock two men down to get position. Here's 1-2. Bird's down and Miley's down.
Look, great shot. Look how high. We showed it again how high they are above the rim. They're playing this game above.
Gilbert was in the second floor window when he reached out his hand, deflected out of the way.
And he's taken about 230 pounds. Watch this right here. Boom, down goes Bird, down goes Miley.
Aguirre makes one of the two free throws. It's 59-51.
Starting to pick up a little bit higher now, trying to force that backcourt turnover.
Bird always there to help out. Garland deflected it out of bounds.
That's where sometime later, if we can, I like to compare Larry Bird's pass to Magic Johnson's passing.
Well, you've kind of vacillated a bit on that. You've said they're both the best you've ever seen this year.
They have different conditions. Larry
Bradshaw. Right open is Bradshaw. He ducked that one.
Yeah, he missed the last one because of indecision. I just feel the momentum is swinging back to the pool. It's down to a six-point lead now.
Oh, almost a backcourt violation, Bird.
Well, you notice Bird hadn't touched the ball for a while. They're going to set him up. Here he comes over the top. They missed him.
Nix. 61-53. Carl Nix with 10.
He wants to win. He wants his mother and father out here on Monday night.
Oh, tough shot.
Aguirre between the leg dribble and hits an 18-footer.
You sure he's only a freshman?
Well, he takes up so much room with a big chest, it's hard to really get on it.
He must have taken a postgraduate course in high school.
Nix is free.
Mitchem doing a pretty good job staying with Bird now, but Bird constantly on the move. There he is.
Nice. Foul on Larry Bird, charging, and that's the third foul on Bird.
Good
what
call.
A pace in this game. Can these two teams maintain the pace?
Let me see it right now. Bird constantly in motion, getting position. Mitchem doing a nice job. Gets over there on the baseline, draws the charge. Good play.
Dick, they can maintain it. This is for all the marbles. This is the shot to go to Monday night, which is what it's all about. They'll dig down deep. Their energy and excitement's down, they'll bring out.
Ball trailing by six. Mitchem trailing by four.
That's another five. He is hitting that jump shot.
13 minutes left.
Larry Bird's coming back to help him bring it up the court now. Well, the jump shot was coming there. He was looking for it.
What a pass. What a pass. Leroy Staley.
That was splendid.
I think some guys get mesmerized when he touches the ball. The defense all looks at him and men cut open for the basket.
Aguirre.
Oh, look at that.
Offensive foul on Aguirre of DePaul. Pushing off.
Well, Miley's been really taking a shove in matching here. Now, here's Bird. He's just going to set up. Now, watch everybody kind of watches it. Bounce pass, beautifully thrown. Leroy Staley has been great off the bench. Lays it on in.
He went back door that time.
No foul and no call.
No, I think it's a good no call right there. Body contact, but nothing major.
The ball back and they're trailing by six. Indiana State with the ball. 12 minutes left. Staley. Garland.
That was a poor shot selection that time. That's two. Oh, there's Aguirre coming from behind.
He's done that in every tournament game. Come up with a little.
He wants the ball.
But he's short. Bird rebounds.
He's pushing a little bit, Al. He really wants the ball badly. What a leader for a freshman.
11 minutes and 40 seconds left.
Usually ball players of big bodies play better in the fourth quarter because they maintain their strength.
Timeout has been called by Indiana State. The Sycamores talk it over, leading by six, 11 and a half remaining.
When is cereal more than just breakfast? When it's grape nuts or shredded wheat. They have a healthy whole grain crunch that may help reduce your risk of heart disease. So start your day the Heart Smart way. Two healthy classics from Post. They're anything but ordinary.
Pick it up, Stinky.
Me? You got no stamina.
Only Odor Readers has new Sorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact.
Get tough with foot odor.
Get Odor Eaters Ultra Durable Insoles.
Reggie Jackson here to introduce you to the best way I've found to improve your hitting. It's the Hitaway.
It's a hit. Improve your swing with Hitaway, the hottest batting tool on the market today. The Hitaway promotes balance, timing, hand-eye coordination, muscle memory, and power mechanics through the simple process of repetitive hitting. Hitaway attaches easily to a tree, post, or pole, and can be used indoors or out with no need for a net, cage, or fence. Throw the ball away from you, and here's the pitch. Every hit winds up the Hitaway so you can hit again and again. And no more chasing balls or paying for batting cages. Because you can move the ball up or down, Hitaway teaches batters to track the ball and get a solid hit anywhere in the strike zone.
Take it from Mr. October. Groove your swing with the Hitaway.
Hitaway for either baseball or softball can be yours for $29.95. And if you call in the next 10 minutes, you'll get our setup and batting tips video, Gorilla Gold Grip Enhancer, and a pair of genuine leather batting gloves absolutely free with your order. And Hitaway comes with a 100% satisfaction guarantee. If you don't see an improvement in the mechanics and fundamentals of your swing, timing, and batting average, simply return it for your money back. Plus, Hitaway makes a great gift. Order two or three. You'll save $5 on each additional Hitaway. Call the toll-free number on your screen now and get the video, the Gorilla Gold Grip Enhancer, and leather batting gloves free with your order. Call now.
On the next Real Classics, Burt Reynolds takes the field with Semi-Tough. To win it all, these guys will try just about anything.
You are going to get pelfed.
I don't like the way it sounds.
You don't even know what it is.
Ow!
And getting to the championship will take everything they got. Plus, Burt talks about what it was like doing his own stunts.
I said, please don't hurt me. And then they went, thud!
Semi-Tough is on Real Classics, hosted by Burt Reynolds. 8 Eastern Sunday, only on ESPN Classic.
Indiana State with a lead by 6 and the ball. 11 minutes, 35 seconds left. Boy, the defensive pressure to really pick it up. That's the thing that's amazing about those shooting statistics is they're playing it against tough defense.
Garland got a piece of the wrist as he reached around. Gary Garland. Bird in the game. Here's an update, men. Tried 16 shots, made 14, 3 out of 4 free throws, 13 rebounds, and 7 assists. That's a month for a lot of players.
I wonder if he ironed the towels.
And he's taking a little break over there. Now this again, as Bill Hodges has been doing this, he wants his guys ready for the big struggle down the end.
Heaton alone. Bob Heaton has his first basket.
We talked about Heaton and Staley coming off the bench. Now, Al, he's going to go ahead and rest his regulars. Ray Meyer doesn't have that advantage. He's been playing with five guys the whole way. And here Indiana State's going to come back with a fresh twosome.
These five are used to it. They're the Iron Men.
Yeah, but it's tough going up against fresh people.
I agree with you, Bill.
Watkins inside to score. Curtis Watkins has 14.
They're keeping the pressure up court on him.
They are, but Bill Hodges is, I think, comfortable to go ahead and trade baskets during this two-minute period.
Turns it over, and there's a break for DePaul.
They put you to sleep, DePaul, Billy. I'm telling you, I've seen them behind many times, and you kind of think you got them on the ropes, and all of a sudden, zip, you're like a cobra.
Taking a look at the two coaches, I think both of them are getting what they want. Bill Hodges really has a lot of guts. Going ahead, taking Bird out of there now. 10 minutes to go, giving them a break.
DePaul, and the foul is on 44, Staley, and Aguirre helped the official with that call. He pointed out the man.
Well, you've got to give a man room to come down. Now, here you go, Bill Hodges gave his men about a minute and a half. They're coming back in. We'll see Aguirre right here. Pushes off a little. You've got to give a man room to come down. That's a good call by the official.
He came down on both feet and didn't move. He did not have room.
That's right.
65-59, Indiana State. Oh, another great block by Gilbert. At 6'7 and a half, he's as fine a leaper as we've seen all year.
And has good timing, doesn't foul in there. You know, he doesn't block needlessly.
His big asset, he's mobile.
Bradshaw inside, can't hit it. And it's out of bounds to Indiana State.
East Orange is named a park at the Bradshaw and Garland. That's a very nice gesture, the city council. No, because all ball players grow up in parks.
Bird will bring it down.
Now we got Watkins back on him again. I think that just happened by accident, because he's got the foul problem.
You got to get off of him.
Reed misses. Mitchem rebounds. The ball on the run. Watkins, he likes the baseline. And DePaul has turned a bit cold here in this run after pulling within six.
They're trying to get it back too quick. They need to get back to their offense.
Curtis got to settle down a little bit. Let Garland give it a try.
And just on cue, Ray Meyer got out both hands, palms down, said, hey, take it easy. And there's a turnover the other way.
Now, Bird was mad at himself right there. He thought he had the angle on the pass. It wasn't available.
Okay, we're coming down the stretch. We just broke the 10-minute mark.
9:45 left. The winner meets Michigan State. Mitchem
He's short. Everyone seems to be short. Miley comes up with a loose ball.
I think they're a little tired. Right before Mitchem took that shot, he was bending over, holding his pants, really trying to get his breath.
DePaul, trailing by six, has had three straight opportunities. If they hit those three.
Oh, what a catch. What a catch.
Drops in another. What a touch.
Oh, that catch was incredible there.
And there are birds all over the lot. Aguirre can't hit. And leading by eight, Indiana State has the ball again.
Al, I think Ray needs to give him a rest timeout right now. They're really tired.
I agree with you. They've got to get the ball into Gary Garland's hands.
Reed.
Walk.
Can't hit.
Oh, there's a foul.
Aguirre to Garland. Three on two to Bradshaw. Yep. Oh, what a drive by Clyde Bradshaw.
Plus the pass.
Baseline violation against Indiana State.
Here we're going to see Ray Meyer hollering at him. Here's Larry Bird constantly moving. Boy, what it must be to try to defense that guy. Look at the hands. Catches the ball, gets in position, squares up to the basket, and makes the shot. Incredible play.
There's a great story about Bob King, his former coach. You know, King was the coach at the start of the year. Bill Hodges wasn't named the official coach till February. There's a lot of love yet between this Sycamore team and Bob King, the veteran coach. Bob Heaton tells the story to Billy Packer.
From the part of your ball club in regard to Coach King and the fact that you fellas mostly were recruited there to play for him, and now he's on the sideline but watching very closely.
Yeah, at the beginning of the year, we dedicated this season to him. And I know at the, you know, very first of the season, we were just had tears in our eyes, you know, seeing up in the stands. And, you know, we really work hard, not just for Coach Hodges, but especially for Coach King. And, you know, he's here with us today and throughout the tournament. And, you know, we're working just as hard for him as we are, you know, for Indiana State University and Coach Hodges.
Bob King suffering a heart attack and then a brain aneurysm and a subsequent operation, and now is just the athletic director at Indiana State, but a great affection with his team. You know, if you were a Hollywood scriptwriter, you'd be cutting emotion a lot of ways. Who do you go for? The veteran DePaul, Coach Meyer, the King-Hodges combination, Indiana State, and the winner will get the Spartans Monday night at 9 o'clock. Gentlemen, Charlie Scott hit 16 field goals for North Carolina against Drake in 69. That is the NCAA semifinal game record. Larry Bird needs just one more to tie.
Go man to man out of bounds, Al. They've gotten by with it twice.
Oh, a travel by Mitchem. Costly turnover to DePaul, trailing by six.
That was a big turnover. Ray Meyer really upset with that one. And here's Bird coming back, meeting the ball. Hey, if you fellas have trouble getting it up, I'll take it. And now they have Aguirre on him.
Traveling Bird.
That wasn't
I don't think so.
That was not a travel. I tell you, he has such a great pump fake. I've seen that called on him three games in a row. He comes to the jump stop and pump fakes. They call it almost every time, but I think it's a good play.
Well, if they call on him, he should stop. Here it is, Bill.
Here he comes. Now watch it. He didn't
You're
walk.
Right. You're right. He doesn't drag the
he
foot.
He does not drag the foot. And look at how he looks back at the official.
DePaul needs a basket to cut the lead to four. It's Aguirre hitting under heavy pressure. 67-63.
He is a tough kid.
Bird. And that great passing instinct. What a man to have the ball under pressure.
Well, he has good vision. He sees the whole court.
Oh, there it is. Nicks inside. Can't hit it. And here comes DePaul, trailing by four. They've cut Indiana State's lead down from 11. Garland.
That's goaltending.
A two-point game. DePaul comes back.
You've got to get the ball in Garland's hand, especially going down the stretch.
Here he is, taking the ball all the way in. Good call by the official. Definitely a goaltend that already hit off the board.
Now we start getting the ball to Larry Bird.
He's going to want it.
Here it is, 22-footer. Unbelievable.
He's going to want that ball, and what's happened to him, he's bringing the ball up the court so they haven't had a chance to get him in offensive position.
His next 2 points put Bird in that exclusive top five all-time. Foul on Gilbert, his second. Neither team in the one-and-one yet. That's Indiana State's 15 fouls, but four against the ball.
That's a very important statistic right now. Who gets the one-on-one first?
Make that 16 fouls on Indiana State for DePaul.
I'll be in it the next time down. Here's that man-to-man again out of bounds.
Watkins scores 69-67. Watkins has 16.
Well, I've said all year, Billy, you just can't play the baseline out of bounds man-to-man. It's impossible.
The double team and Reed now.
Yeah, Mitchem is doing a nice job on Bird.
Hats up.
Bird. Mitchem. Saved by Watkins. Mitchem with the defense. DePaul looking for a tie. Deflected. That was Nix.
Ooh, a quick hand by Garland that time. Try to return the turnover.
6:40 left.
Setting up a new offensive structure right here. They're clearing out. Larry Bird on his side all by his own, trying to get the ball down low.
Nix. Carl Nix. Mitchem rebounds, Nix steals it, Mitchem blocks, and Bird takes it away.
Beautiful play.
Gilbert scores.
Oh, great basketball. Great college basketball. Let's see that again. That was outstanding.
You know, you can't show a replay because there's a good play coming right up right after it. Super.
71-67.
It's a shame one of these teams have to lose.
I felt the same way about the Arkansas game, Al. You hated to see Sidney Moncrief have to bow out.
Superman, Sidney.
Inside, Aguirre, he scores. 71-69, Mark Aguirre has 17. Great balance, Watkins 18, Aguirre 17, Garland 16.
Mitchem asked Ray Meyer to come out, and he said, no, just hang in there, or he's exhausted.
Bird alone emotionally must make you feel...
he's leaning on Larry Bird.
Nix can't hit, and DePaul has a chance to tie.
The clock is very important right here. DePaul could use this basket.
I don't know if it's not a bad idea for them to hold the ball a little bit.
Aguirre ties it up.
There's holding the ball.
Aguirre, 71 apiece. They've made up 11 points.
There's Margaret Mary. She never calls.
Oh, bad pass.
Garland, DePaul takes the lead, 73-71.
Bill Hodges hasn't called the timeout. I think he wants to keep the pressure on, but it's been really tough for him.
Rebound, Aguirre, the freshman, taking over with 4.5 minutes left.
Ray will call a timeout and go to a spread offense.
Timeout to Paul. And now we'll see the strategy employed by Maguire. His team has come from behind. 11 points down. They lead by 2, and there's 4.5 minutes remaining.
What am I? Am I a basketball player who's a psychology major? Or am I a psychology major who's a basketball player? You know, that's the thing about psychology. We tend to overanalyze everything.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Handle to Gervin down low. Gervin takes a shot. Good! 33
Moses. Shoot it, Moses.
Robinson with authority.
What'd you have to eat?
Pound of beer-battered chicken strips and cheese fries.
You?
A watercress tea sandwich.
Should have had a Hungry Man sports grill. Hungry Man, it's good to be full.
Hey, life on a street stinks.
We need odor protection.
Only Odor Eaters has new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact.
Don't just fight foot odor and wetness.
Whack it with Odor Eaters Ultra Comfort insoles.
John Wooden, Rick Pitino, two legendary coaches, back to back. Sports Century John Wooden premieres at 8 p.m. Monday, followed by the premiere of Sports Century Rick Pitino at 8:30, only on ESPN Classic.
What if you could go back in time?
You are watching what greatness is all about.
One unforgettable game started it all. Now, 25 years later, 25 straight hours. Magic versus Bird, all day today on ESPN Classic.
You've reached Jack Conrad. I'm out of town. If you need to reach me this weekend...
I'll be in the Luvuvu River in southern Africa, for there I am king.
So leave a message and...
Sunday, an adventure so real, you'll feel like you're there. When water is wealth, crocodiles are kings. Reptile Rulers, Sunday at 9 on the National Geographic Channel, Channel 276.
Ernestine Tamlin here, WebEx communications visionary and all-around operator. If you're still showing up for meetings in person, I feel sorry for you. And sympathy doesn't come easy to me. The hassle, the waste of time and money makes me just want to take you and shake you. That's why you need WebEx online meetings. Connect with more customers with less stress and more success. We've got to start meeting like this.
Sign up to start meeting online and get your free trial today.
And for a while, it appeared it would be the Bird against Magic Monday night. But the 11-point Indiana State lead has melted away under fierce defensive pressure from DePaul. The Demons now are in front by two, and DePaul has the ball. Now, Indiana State had everything going its way. Now, how do you analyze the last 7-8 minutes?
In basketball, Dick, you can only keep going for so long. You've got to end up with a drought, and then the other team starts moving. That's what momentum comes, to keep swinging back and forth. I could feel momentum swinging to DePaul about 4 or 5 minutes ago, and I said it. Yeah. And so now it's a tight ball game. I think Ray will spread it out and try to get to the 1-1. There's a lifetime left, obviously, 4 minutes and 20 seconds.
And, of course, he's in pretty good foul shape because his team only has 4 fouls. And Indiana State is sitting on 6, so the fouls from now on against DePaul will take the Demons to the line. And a good opportunity for fellas in the front court to rest. DePaul did this very well against UCLA and came up with a lot of layups.
They're going to turn the ball over. They can't do it this long. They need to pick up a foul or turn the ball over. They're looking to isolate 1-1. They'd like to get Garland on the side, 1-1, and go around Bob Heaton. They are.
Oh, he kicked it out.
What a hustle.
Out of bounds to Indiana State.
You can't hold the ball that long, Dick. There's too much time left in the game. They have to go for the shot.
And here's Bill Hodges coming back in with his offensive players, coming in with Steve Reed. Reed, the sophomore, has made some clutch shots, sent in by the 36-year-old head coach of the Sycamores in his first season. Named the coach of the year. What a dream story that is.
And Dick, Al was talking about drops. I think another factor for Indiana State was the fact that they had to use Bird to bring the ball up the court, which took him out of the offensive area during that big run by DePaul. Now he's back down in there.
Good point. Al Bird is where he likes to be.
Yeah, but DePaul's in the zone now. Excuse me, they're in a 2-3.
Bird, what a pass. Tie it at 73. And a beautiful assist by Larry Bird.
I still think, Al, the box and one is something to be thinking about against them because he's going to have a lot of help in that. If that comes, we'll come after a timeout.
Aguirre way off the mark. That's Bob Heaton with a rebound, and now it shifts to Indiana State.
We're getting very close to the chess game. Let's see what Indiana State does.
I think they ought to keep getting that ball in Bird's hands. Forget about holding it.
The ball changed their defense again. They went to man-to-man. Bird's going to try to post up Mitchem. Watch Heaton come out and pick Mitchem.
It's a set play right here. They move Bird in low. 2:40 left.
Terre Haute against Chicago.
How about their high school teams in the finals tonight also? Having a pretty good year down there at their home.
Well, the bird's wings spread very wide.
And Al, as opposed to holding the ball here, they're running their offense, looking for the shot. They're not looking to hold it.
DePaul is toughing off, trying to block up the middle. He'll put it up. Knicks.
Can't hit. Mitchem, who has been a terror on the defensive boards. He's played an outstanding game. I think we've overlooked his total play today.
Paul Knicks had the shot, it just didn't
almost threw it out of bounds.
Watkins had his back to the ball. Someone yelled, he turned and caught the pass.
But just caught the 2 minute mark. That's very important time. Squash tie out there.
Got to remember, neither team in the 1-1. So it's a good idea to foul a man if he's beating you to the basket because they're only going to get it out of bounds.
Now, Indiana State is Philly.
No, it's 6-4.
Yeah, but the next one's 1-1.
Okay, 7.
Foul against Knicks. Knicks commits the foul. It's only his third, and it will send DePaul to the line. 1-1.
1-1.
Look right up. You know, there have been shots of hockey players' faces and all the stitches. Look at the years. Look at the wins. Look at the losses in that face. Ray Meyer.
Tough man, but a good man. Great competitor. The years I played against him, we really had great battles. Back and forth.
Gary Garland to break the tie. 1-1.
He's the man they want there. Starting to strum on that banjo.
That's the assistant to Meyer, Ken Cerruti. They got some, only one.
They've got some real fine fouls. Did you see Larry Bird pass the ball off and say, come on, let's go get it?
There goes your overtime. They're on an odd number.
Oh, what a pass.
And Bird is fouled.
Let's see if he's going to get
two. Aguirre got the foul, Mark Aguirre, and for the freshman, that's his fourth.
Well, there's no basket, so he won't be shooting it at all. They said it wasn't a basket. Here we go. Beautiful pass. Holly had it, just kind of lost it a little bit going up. Kept it active, goes up again. Here's Bird coming in, powers the rebound. They'll get it out of bounds. And that's the 15th foul, so they've got one more to go after this for 1-1.
The ball is playing a 3-2 zone out of bounds underneath. Had to clear the ball out high. Okay, good ball.
You see the clock, time remaining. A tie game has been broken on Garland's free throw. 74-73 to Paul. A foul, Mitchem holding Bird away from the ball. No shots on this one. That's
okay,
six.
Now the next one will be 1-1.
What was it? You see Ray Meyer up there a little upset with that foul because you don't want to make an unnecessary one. That was a big advantage not to be in a 1-1.
And Mitchem is the third DePaul player saddled with four fouls, so that's a story too.
Right down to the wire. Gotta throw it out high. That's it.
You're in that zone, but they know where Bird is. They're doing a good job concentrating on Bird when he touches the ball.
Plenty of time left.
The winner against Michigan State. Oh. Heaton scores. Indiana State leads by one with 48 seconds left.
Wow, that was some pass. Wow. Got to call timeout. They got to call timeout, DePaul.
All right. Ray Meyer heard you.
What brings you to the Rhode Island Culinary Institute?
That's a good question.
What brings you to Southern New Mexico State?
You travel many miles. Why Gestalt School of Art?
What made you decide to make the trip all the way to Memphis Polytech?
139 a week for any compact car at Budget. For irresistible prices on irresistible cars, call 1-800-BUDGET-7 or visit budget.com.
I gotta call my dad. The man just got unseated.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah, it's T. Yeah, I just had a burger at Sonic, and it's the best burger I ever had. Yeah, better than yours.
But it's no reflection on you as a man.
That's fresh, made to order. Sonic does it, others don't. It's Sonic good.
When the kids left home, so did we.
We're traveling more and spending less.
Yeah, we discovered Extended Stay America.
It's a great deal, no matter how long we stay. For a night, a week, or even longer.
Clean, comfortable, lots of room. There's even a full kitchen at Extended Stay America.
Personally, I love this recliner.
Why pay more and just get a little hotel room?
And with all this, it's such a great price.
Why would we stay anywhere else?
When is cereal more than just breakfast? When it's grape nuts or shredded wheat. They have a healthy whole grain crunch that may help reduce your risk of heart disease. So start your day the Heart Smart way. Two healthy classics from Post. They're anything but ordinary.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Susan. I'm Frank's friend, Steve.
Of course you are.
Nice to meet you.
Come on in. Dinner's almost ready.
Oh, I thought we were going out. I made reservations.
Oh, no. I made lasagna. Oh, don't worry. I used soy cheese because I know that you're lactose intolerant.
Okay.
Oh, gosh. Try this on.
Wow, you made this for me?
Yeah, I learned how to knit online. It's really no big deal. And these. And this. Okay. Let's go meet my parents.
Special treatment. Bad idea for blind dates? Good idea for online trading. Ameritrade Apex is our premier active trading program. Get special benefits like the latest trading tools, access to exclusive webcasts, and discounts on research products.
Hi, Steve.
Sign up now and get $100 if you qualify for Apex, plus 25 commission-free internet equity trades. Go to ameritrade.com/apex/ or call 866-368-4610.
Ugh. My feet ache.
They don't smell so great either.
Only Odor Eaters Plus Arch Support insoles have new Zorbitex technology to absorb sweat and destroy odor on contact. Revives tired feet.
Give foot ache and odor the boot with Odor Eaters Plus.
Baseball's back. Now relive the greatest games from the 2003 playoffs. Plus the story behind the curse of the Babe and the Billy Goat. All day Sunday, April 4th. Then at 7 p.m., the ESPN original documentary. Only on ESPN Classic.
What if you could go back in time?
You are watching what greatness is all about.
One unforgettable game started it all. Now, 25 years later, 25 straight hours. Magic versus Bird, all day today on ESPN Classic.
That's Ray Meyer's son with the glasses to our right. Ken Sarubi, Joe Meyer, who's a brilliant basketball tactician. There's a lot of rumors that he might replace his father at DePaul, but you heard Ray before the game. He has no designs on retiring.
He's not leaving till he's 70. That's the requirement in the Vincentian school there. Ray, the son has never called him father. He always calls him coach. Margaret Mary, the wife right there, also calls him coach.
You mean that after 40 years of marriage, when they hug each other, give each other a kiss goodnight, she says, good night, coach?
And they're going to be married 40 years this May 27th.
That's marvelous. She's a lovely lady. Now, we've got quartet of coaches have talked it over. Each of you take your shot at it, Billy. What do you think they're saying? Then we'll give Al his chance.
Well, obviously, I think if I'm Ray Meyer, I want to get the ball inside to Aguirre. If he does, all the pressure's on the defense, and the kid wants the ball. Even though he's a freshman, I like his guts on the inside. And, of course, if you're down here and you're Indiana State, you want to go ahead and get that ball to Larry Bird and let him create.
What I say they're talking about over the Indiana State huddle, they're saying, all right, there's 36 seconds left. If the ball scores, let's call an immediate timeout. Let's come out into a 2-3 zone. I don't know if they'll do it or not. Make him shoot from the outside. Overplay Garland. I say that what Ray is saying right here, we got plenty of time left. Let's look for the good shot. Let's take the shot. If we can't get it, we'll call another timeout with about 15 seconds to go.
You know, I've always wanted to ask someone this question, ask it on the air. 36 seconds to go. You're down by one, but you have the ball. Some would say you'd rather have the ball, get the last shot. Others would say, well, I'd rather have that little one-point lead, the other team with the ball. What would you rather?
I'd rather have the lead. Percentages in your advantage.
Even though the other guys have the ball.
Yeah. Because you don't score over 50% of your shots in a game.
All right. In that case, Indiana State's in the catbird seat, but delicately so.
36 seconds.
Will they go for the last shot?
We'll see in a moment. They're in the zone. No, they're not.
No, they're man-to-man. They played man-to-man the whole game. Had never touched it. Boy, they're going to hold it down about 15. They called another time.
Gary Garland.
Boy, this is dangerous.
Right man got the ball, and he can put it in Garland's hands. Okay, I think they got to call another timeout.
Well, they're going for the win.
Oh, one shot. The gambling. You're going to know when to hold. You're going to know when to fold.
Aguirre.
Can't go. It's their ball. Over. It's over. Congratulations.
Oh, no, there's 1 second left.
Why did he shoot
one
the ball?
Left.
Why did he shoot the ball?
It's not over, and there's 1 second left.
Well, they're calling an intentional foul. It'll be a two-shot foul.
It appears Indiana State has earned its ticket to that final game in a perfect year, but it's not over. Ray Meyer has gone down to congratulate Bill Hodges on the far sidelines. A concession speech by Meyer, and Hodges says, hey, wait.
It isn't
wait
till over. I win it. Yeah, he said it's not over yet. Leroy Staley was grabbed, and that's why there's a two-shot clock. Ray's saying throw it down there. I can't believe they wouldn't call a timeout, Al.
Well, they're nervous. They're young. That's why they're in college. They're not professionals. But every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser. That was some gamble they took.
If he misses the shot, the clock starts, not when it hits the rim, but when it touches a player in play.
No, when it hits the rim, Dick,
it hits the rim.
Yeah. But if it doesn't hit the rim, it doesn't start.
It's all she wrote. The game's over. Okay?
Well, if he makes it, they can call time.
I think it'd be a smart move to get the players from Indiana State out of there so they don't push him an rebound.
He should miss the shot on purpose, Billy.
Yeah, but he might miss the whole rim.
He should miss it on purpose.
He didn't.
That's a mistake.
Time out. They did call time. Now they have a final chance to tie the game.
That's a mistake. Now there's a second left on the clock. That means there's more than a second.
Possibly.
Okay, there could be a second and a half, a second and three fourths. What they'll do now, go back to the Olympic game many years ago in Munich, was it? Where they throw the long pass and you go back to us in the semifinals against Charles of North Carolina when Butch Lee threw the ball down to, I forget the guy's name.
How about the aircraft?
Who's my man?
Jerome
Whitehead, the guy that made me famous, I forgot him. How I remember my good friends.
Indiana State, with 1 second remaining, has a two-point lead. The desperation throw will be delivered by Garland. He has four teammates down court.
What they should do is put a man on Garland, a tall man. Great coaching. They're putting Gilbert there. He'll jump, will force Garland to throw the ball higher, which allows the defense down court to adjust to the ball.
There it is.
There it goes. Oh,
good play. And Indiana State has won it. The Sycamores are 33-0. It'll be that dream matchup. Irvin Johnson of Michigan State, Larry Bird of Indiana State on Monday night. And the most valuable player, Larry Bird, Indiana State, was the running dog. $1,000 to the Indiana State University in the name of their great All-American Larry Bird. We have seen two brilliant athletes at their best today. Bird of the Sycamores, Irvin Magic Johnson of Michigan State, and we'll see them again. Is that a basketball fan's delight? Monday night at 9 for the national title. And we'll be back to talk to both winning and losing coaches.
Our final, Indiana State 76, DePaul 74, a very happy couple, Coach Bill Hodges and his wife, Connie. Last week, Arkansas by one, today by two. Don't you do anything easy?
Well, I thought we were going to do it easy, but, Ray just coached a heck of a game. They forced us into some things that we don't normally do. And, it really was tough at the end, a heck of a ball game.
There was a period there with about 8 minutes to go, 65-59, when it seems both teams lost their concentration, turned it over up and back. Was that the case, or was everybody getting a little cautious?
Called fatigue, I believe, Brian. I think we were tired. I know they were tired. They went with five men, and, that's what causes lack of concentration.
I know the coach appreciated the effort over there, Billy.
Well, Mitchem asked to come out of the ball game one time, and Ray just said, stay out there. You got to gut it out. One of the things, Bill, that I was interested in is the last shot when you had the timeout. Did you think they were going to go into Aguirre down low?
Well, I thought they would post him up, but, they use that four corner so much. It's also a heck of an idea to give the ball to Garland and let him try to score because, he's taking it in. He's a great foul shooter. We just didn't want to foul. I'll tell you, when they got a one-point lead on us with a minute and a half to go, I knew they were going to the four corner. We're pretty good against the four corner.
Connie, save one more kiss for the guy. You said a kiss for every game.
Bill and Connie Hodges, congratulations. Let's go cross court. Dick Enberg has Coach Ray Meyer.
It spells out the class of this man that he's waited to talk to us in defeat as he was in victory against UCLA last week. Coach to coach, what would you like to ask Ray?
Ray, I'd like to know, with 35 seconds left in the game, you were down by 1 point. What did you tell your ball players?
I told our ball players to get it inside, but don't wait till the last shot. Get it up, and if we miss it, we want to foul Miley or whatever, the 27% free throw.
Gilbert, yeah.
We wanted to foul him right away. We waited too long for the shot, and we took a forced shot. Gary had one from the free throw line and passed it up.
I thought Gary was going to take that.
That was his shot, yeah. We made a couple of mistakes with three men out. We threw the ball away once, and go back and...
Hey, but your kids made a great...
Get Margaret in here. Thank you.
But your kids showed such remarkable poise. Coach, you were down by 11 to a great basketball team, and you came back and had victory almost there.
Well, Dick, basketball, like every team sport, is a game of mistakes. We made a couple of mistakes at the wrong time. And Indiana State's a very fine ball club. They shot very well. No matter how we try to tell our boys not to turn their heads when Bird gets the ball, they still do it. And we give them a little layup and a little free throw here and there. But I'm proud of our boys. They played well. They never quit. They always try to come back.
Thank you, Ray, for joining us. Congratulations on a great year and great basketball. We're going to go now to Brian Gumbel and Larry Bird.
Okay, Dick Enberg, thank you very much. Billy Packer, I know you want one quick question with the big guy.
Well, Larry, super ball game. Magic, before the game, said he loves to watch you play because you come up with things he never saw before. How about your chance to play against them?
Well, I know it's going to be a great game. I just hope we don't get blown out like Penn did. I just want to go out. We're here now, and you never did say we'd get here, so we're going to do it.
Well, you're really showing me up. Great game, Larry.
Michigan State, Indiana State, Monday night. Let's go back to Dick Enberg.
Now, the final score, Indiana State defeats DePaul by 2, 76-74.
The world premiere of